Okay, so now we've kind of laid down the groundwork for that. You understand what pH is. You know what the normal pH is, 7.35 to 7.45. We've looked at CO2. It's controlled by the lungs. Normal level, 35 to 45. We've looked at bicarb, which is, we're going to say, controlled by the kidneys. It's really the whole metabolic system. Normal levels are 22 to 26. Now we're going to start at the end. The end product of where your patient is one of four places, just like your favorite multiple choice test, right? We either have respiratory acidosis or metabolic acidosis. You have respiratory alkalosis or metabolic alkalosis. Now, just knowing those names, we can see all kinds of things about your patient. So let's take a look at the name and see what's involved. Let's look at respiratory acidosis. So the name tells us whose fault it is. Because we're in respiratory acidosis, we know it's the lungs' fault. Acidosis tells we where we are. Like, you know, look at that couch again. If we're saying that their pH is acidotic, that means that it's not between 7.35 and 7.45. It's somewhere beyond off that couch, so it's lower than 7.35. Now, to help you remember this, you might want to write the values of the pH again in on your own notes over the couch of homeostasis. So if a patient is in respiratory acidosis, that means it's the lungs' fault that we got there, and where we are is acidosis. So your pH is less than 7.35. Now, for those of you that are already racing ahead, I want to give you a question just to see if you understand. If it's the lungs' fault that we're in acidosis, what do the lungs control? CO2 levels. Okay, so would it take a higher CO2 level or a lower CO2 level to become more acidotic? Right, it would take a higher CO2 level. Well, that would mean, are my lungs breathing way too fast or not sufficiently enough? In order for CO2 to build up, that means my lungs are not hyperventilating. For some reason, I'm not breathing effectively. Now, it could be that
you're trying to strangle me.
Or it could be that you've taken too many opiates and so your breathing really is shallow. Or it could be an asthma attack or maybe a COPD attack. Any one of those things that causes me to breathe inefficiently will cause CO2 to build up. The more CO2 that builds up, the more acidotic my pH will become. That's why we showed you the couch and got you moving that way. Okay, now what about metabolic alkalosis? Well, I know the first part of the name tells me whose fault it is. So if it's metabolic, right, that's the kidneys and the bicarb level. If I'm alkalosis, where are we on the couch? Is our pH less than 7.35 or greater than 7.45? Good deal. It's greater than 7.45. We're in alkalosis. So metabolic alkalosis, that tells us the reason we're in alkalosis is the metabolic system's fault. Okay, so normal values, 7.35 to 7.45, 35 to 45 for CO2, 22 to 26 for bicarb. I know you've heard those over and over and over again. That's because I want you to study as you go with us, and that way you'll know these by the end of the video.